problems, you'll see horizontal lines moving across the picture during about the first 10 minutes of this tape, and then again briefly at about 1 hour. Our apologies for that. We thought you'd rather see the action than have us simply edit out the material. Hope you enjoy the tape.
Just got here after about 38 hours of travel. Chang Zhan, the phenomenal Chinese Olympic champion. You know, it's gradually just starting to warm up now. 60 kilos. Got a real different angle here now. It's really crowded in here. Here, second set. Yeah, 90 kilos. There's really a lot of activity going on here. I think there's only 17 platforms, and most of them are casual. Got swimming. 50 kilos just starting this warm up. Hey, he's looking thick as a brick. Supposed to be in good shape. And Jack and John, 100 kilos. That's the coach. He's just right in front of us. Just to guard away. 100 kilos again. Sunny Paludian, second set, 90 kilos. Yes. This is a semi-outdoor training hall. This is the outer perimeter of a stadium. That was Coach Yang in front of us. 110. And Coach is right here. They have Coach. 110. That intentional release again at the top. It's pretty hot and humid here. It's probably about 80 degrees or so. It's real hot. It's just steamy. Sean's wearing the style of brushing. This band's otherwise flying. It's still really warm. Mechanically easy. .120 double. 7.7. It's .130. So we have Bluetooth. Okay, I'm going to pick up Balut's second rep. This is his double. The same weight, 130. Now, Andre, boom. Same 130. 70 kilo lift and then a 99 kilo lift. Can't resist. I've got to try. It's probably Laura way down at the end of the training. There's too much going on here. It's like you tape early and it's going on at once. Say, this place is just hot. There's 140. And then the big weights. Easy. Here's Sunday. The lead coming out for 150. Competition starts tomorrow. I don't think I managed to mention that. Within 10 minutes, four names came walking in this park. It was just a steady stream. It was everyone. Yotov, Batman was just training. The Cubans came walking in the park. Etc., etc., etc. It's just more people than I can even name. We got 140 again. We got 160 going over here. 40 again. We got 145. There's a little consultation with the coach and the coach. And they just agreed to go up. 145. Wow, look at that. Guys, you see? Well, look at this. Jean Chukan. This is 150. Big lift. Kilo lifter. 150 kilos in the bar. Boom. Sean Chukan again with 150. Trying to get an idea of the intensity of this place looking past him. 150 once again, different angle. Boom. You can see Coach Garrett behind him sitting on a bench. He's been loaded in most of the sets. In fact, here he comes right now to help load. Real hands up. Looks like that's it for the snatching. Well, he did a lot of work. Great workout. One and only Pablo R. This is 150. Looks like they're going up. Probably again with the same 150. Well, of course, remember, this isn't really his lift. I mean, Gershberry really shines, but yeah, he's kind of surprised about that. Here's Sean, he's starting to warm up on his clean Gershberry, but he's a squat jerker. You can see him do it sweeter than that. Just up back at the 150 again. Cuban team is really actively cheering for each other. A lot of energy going around here. Sean, the second warm-up set. 80 kilos. Here's Sean with 100. Look at that. I don't know how many sets I missed, so it's a lot again. This is 130. People were talking about the power cleans he was doing down to the pitch in the drink hall. 180 real casually, probably 190 one day. World record holder in the clean. Boom. Got 130 again. John, we got 140 going over here. A little step forward, but a little routine at this time. Looks like 140. We got 170 going here. Look at that. 76 kilo lifter. You saw him just smoke this 170. Look at that pause. Remember, this is almost 100 kilos over body weight. This is 160, it looks like. Squatcher. Boom. Easy. You are going after 170. Guys, as I said, they really did cheer for each other. Quiet out of respect for this lift. Not a lightweight. 190. Yep. 160. Sixty back offset. 160 or Sune. Boom. He's looking to be in good shape. Here's 180. If you saw this guy, you'd think he played table tennis. Great athlete. 180. Feel it. Yeah, Sune over here. Real heavy action here today in the 76s. This is Mehmet Yılmaz from Turkey. This is 200 kilos. We've seen 190 today. Earlier, so I looked up to 190. And also a 76 kilo lifter. And here we go with 200. I said, I'd actually be surprised if we were making it. Pretty close. This is Balut with 240. You know, I thought he was going to lift 99 because he's looking real beefy. How's that for you? He's actually lifting 91. 240. This is a 200 kilo front squat. He, of course, he couldn't have run a shirt yet, but so much. He's been front squatting with that mass. I don't know if that might be the last set or not, but I thought he's picked that up. Pretty routine 200 kilo front squat for him. Here's some Urban Batman. He dropped back down to 190. The coach told me that he had knee surgery not too long ago. And then about a month after his rehab, he started having problems again, so his legs aren't in top shape. It was 190. I'd see him wince a little bit. Elmez again, with 200 again. Routine. 76 kilo lifter. Pablo Lara just starting to warm up. Saturday morning, it's about 10 o'clock. Cuban team just came in, just warming up. I tell you, we rarely get to watch Pablo Lara actually train, so this is going to be a real treat. Second warm set. Clean grip snatches, 50 kilos. World champion, Olympic champion, world record holder, great weightlifter, great athlete. And it's not an exaggeration to say Pablo Lara is one of the favorites among hardcore weightlifting fans in the U.S. Just does some stunning things. Third warm-up set. I won't be surprised this morning. It's just kind of loosening up. Section, we'll see, and then maybe come back this afternoon for something heavy. I'll certainly try to be here if there's a second work Cuban team today. As I say, it's unusual to be able to watch them train. This is probably one of the most explosive groups of athletes you'll find on the face of Earth. A lot of people might take issue with that. I'll say, not probably, but definitely. Same 100 kilos again. say 120 again. We're probably some 4 days out at this point. 76 is a rough class. It's probably going to end up being the most competitive class of this World Championships. Pretty bold this early since lifting the team started, but it's really going to be tough. It's going to be tough, and it's going to be really, really tight. This is 130 here. Probably just moved up. We're at 140. Looks like we're going over clean jerks. Remember, when you're watching, this is the world's best. Just look. Right. 76 kilo lifter. I think his world record right now is 208. They're about. Power clean's 180, unbelievably easily. Power clean's 190. 120 again. You know, we're looking at such a gifted athlete that you can almost lose sight of the fact that he's already up to close to double body weight. I know this is just a trivial weight for him, but this is already close to double body weight. Here's an idea just how powerful he is. Same 140 again. With double body weight. same 160 again. 160 kilos. Split jerk right at 160 kilos, just like that. This is a lightweight form, but no warm-ups on those. Just some push jerks straight to the split jerk. Time to squat, it looks like now. Time for some front squats. 100 kilos. You know, it's worth pointing out here that, you know, everyone knows you're supposed to back out of the squat rack. When you're clear, you can walk back in, forward up. Look, lost his grip. Right on. But see, Pablo Lara, world champion, et cetera, doesn't do it that way. So if something works for you, even if everyone else is doing it some other way, do what works for you. This is 160. Basically no rest at all, just threw the plates on and ready to go. This is 200 kilos. And we fully expect Pablo Lara to injure a little bit more than this when he competes. You know, probably going to stand up with this pretty easily. But still, we're getting serious weight. 200 kilos, 76 kilo lifter. Not even a change in expression. How do you like it? Hold on to your eyeballs, it's T30. Now this is about the weight that used to be considered a Herculean back squat by a 250-pound guy. 230-kilo front squat, 76-pound guy, routine light workout in the morning, a few days out from the World Championship.
Yep.
Looks like he's going to bang it out again. Just goes to show, this is just the working weight for this guy. 230 kilos, 76 kilo lifter. He's got little knee wraps on, so I guess it's a no-no front squat. This is a mind-boggling foot, though. Actually, he's got a belt on, sorry, it's just a no. Anyway, extremely. Joe Toyota just started off. Definitely the number one guy, and Yoto probably most people looked up the number two guy in the world, 76 kilo class. This is one of the hardest working guys in weightlifting. Serious from the get-go, first set. Completely serious. Not goofing around at all. This is a professional work. I think I did a couple more warm-ups. That's with 15. I just got in tape those guys up to 70. About his fourth set overall. Moving very slow. I'd expect this to be light workout. Last night I saw him clean and jerk 190, which is a big lift. Very workmanlike the way he trains. Everything's very deliberate, very serious, even with these lightweights. So this is Kim Min Young from North Korea, 70 kilo lifter. This is 230 kilos. He just tripled 200 very easily. He's been snatching 155, I guess, every single day in here. 230 kilos, look at this. How do you like that? Strong or what? Same lifter, 240. I guess the set before was actually 220, not 230. 70 kilo lifter. 240 kilos. Watch this. Right. Chinese team just came in and starting to warm up. That's Zhugang Zhang down there, listening up his knees. Now, Saturday afternoon, by the way, so hopefully we're going to get to see what consecutive days training look like for him. We've read about how the Chinese train, we're going to see it in practice. Just listening up. Jean continuing to loosen up. I think he's getting ready to start to put some weights on here pretty soon. I've skipped a lot of the stretching and warming up, but just wanted to give you an idea how he's loosening up. Spent some time sitting down in here, just sitting, kind of looking, I think, trying to get psyched for the workout. Let's see how heavy he goes. I'm going to pick this up. Jean's been doing these clean deadlift and shrug kind of movements, just as I assume warm up. We'll see if he does any more. Yeah, he's putting more on, so he's going to keep it warm. I'll try to do a better job of taping the next set. Here's Sune Blute, up to 110. I missed his first couple warm-ups. Once again, we saw him train yesterday, so they can compare what he does today to yesterday. Movement. Clean deadlifts and shrugs, pretty much. Really surprised me to see him doing this. 3 days after competing, 190. Kind of squeezing the shot here, it's too tight. Missed a whole bunch of sets over here, but now you get blocked yet again. Yeah, here's soon. Sunny Blutz up to 30. Looks like 150 to me. I'll check my math. Yeah, it's 150. He's got a bunch of little plates on there. Okay, I'm gonna try again to squeeze in the John's guy, I just want to show you. So it's 15. I think what he's doing is he's just warming up for the clean, obviously. Okay, correction. That last set was actually 220. There was an extra 2.5 inside each one, the one I could see. Jim Fulton overcounted. He wasn't sure. Anyway, he went up to 240 now, which surprised me. I mean, I'm surprised he went up for another set. Again, just the idea, I think he's getting used to handling the weight, well, now, you know, notch above what he's going to clean and jerk. So it's a clean deadlift and shrug, not really a pull. He's going to take the weight off the floor the way you would if he were cleaning it, but it's also going under control and now quite a bit heavier than what he's actually going to do. Play a jerk post, but an easier way to lift it. Very surprising to see him doing this 3 days. I mean, not a lot of people predict this. It looks like he's going to do more. Here goes 240 again. Just one time, it's going to be a clean shot. It's going to get You can kind of see it. 240. Same movement. This is 220, I think. Interesting, he came back down that. Anyway, that's what he's been doing. And that was 220. I had to come down here and show you what Sean's doing over here on the jerks. It's going to be just like what he was doing. He's going to do a little partial move. Look at this. 210. Little overload in an easy way, getting ready for the big lift. 250. Same thing. Good. I think his full record's 195. And this 250 again, just warming up for the jerk. This 230 that Sinich's got over here, he's supposedly an 83 kilo lifter. He front squats 280, the coach told me, back squats 300. This is 230. Pretty easy. And here comes a pretty big front squat. This is 260, 83 kilos, 97 inch from Turkey. Can you believe this? You can see the curve on the bar. Big lift. I thought he was going to do it. Oh, wow, this is another pretty heavy front squat. It's going to bang out. This is 200. Actually, looks like he's training in his underwear, but don't tell him when I said it. There's 200 in his underwear. 3 days. I'm back in the training hall Sunday morning. We got a Cuban team came in to train. Got Pablo Lara again. Just having a few warm-up sets. He's up to 100 kilos right now. I'm off to the side. Actually, I try to avoid some of the backlight, but it's probably going to be interesting because you can follow his back and hip positions a lot better this way. This 130. That last set that I said was 100 was actually 110. There was a 5 inside that bumper that I didn't see until they're stripping down the bar. Thank you. taking some time getting ready for the second rep. Sunday, so I thought it was 3 days out. I got 140 here. Characteristic little cry or whistle before a lot of the Cubans do this. I think it helps their concentration. Just went right into this. Yeah, one of my earliest memories of Papa Water was seeing him at the 90 Goodwill. Looking diagonally on the platform. He doesn't seem to be bothered at all if the bar's not squared up with the platform. Looks wherever it lands, even if it's at a 45 degree angle. Handles like a toy. 1:07. It's only about 10:30 in the morning. The guys who weigh this, 76 kilos and clean and jerk 1:07 at 10:30 in the morning, especially after doing it. not sure if he missed that. I think his hand's bothering him. He's been looking at that right hand the whole workout. Hope he's not tearing callus. Let's see. Here we go again, 170. Give him a little encouragement. I think that hand is bothering him. Pablo's actually treating this way pretty soon. Some instructions from the coach on that one. I'm not the jerk. I guess even when you're a world champion, look at you, you're still fine-tuning. Always fine-tuning. So I think he'd be jerks from that. I assume he was going to squat. Yeah, look at this. They're really checking out his jerk. Squatting time, 140 first set. Didn't even put the plates on the bar in the same order. I don't know if you can see that. Nice small jump here. This is 210. 140 first set. Easy, huh? 250. They kind of just cleared the stage for me. Of course, then 210 just did. That's about what he cleans and jerks. But here's a 250 squat in the morning. 76 kilo lifter. A couple days before the Worlds. He's got a belt and little knee wraps, but this is 250 kilos. Olympic style. Like that. Yeah. Here he goes, Ulysses doing it again. Just to show that this is just kind of a working weight for him. Then this is the 250. But still got it, I think. Okay, it's Sunday afternoon. We're going to try to follow this. We're going to loop through a whole crowd here for a warm-up. he's going to go fairly heavy today. Maybe something like 170, 200, but we'll see. He's 5 days out. He's forming up with 50 kilos. We got 50 kilos again. Hardly any rest at all. He's still using straps, not too unusual, just a few days out. He's not going to be bothered at all going into the contest. He's coming off a lot of training with straps. Some people get mental block about that, but it's common for top lifters. Throws his head to the top of his pole. Of course, Dimas does that too. It doesn't seem to hurt him at all. 60. This looks like the first weight that Sinead's starting to think about a little bit. 160. He's thinking, getting a little psyched. 170 is pretty serious weight. 91 kilo class. I wouldn't really expect it to quite be a medal, but it's getting up there. Thank you.
around 160. They were pretty happy with that snatch, I think. Alright. Just starting clean jerks now. Took maybe, about a 20 minute break. 50 kilos. I guess that maybe we'll see that up. Second set, 90 kilos. This thing is elbows up 200, doesn't even rack in the bar. That head back. Pretty easy clean recovery, huh? Boom. Easy jerk. Okay, guys. Assuming I went to 210 on this. Kind of surprised me, but it was a little heavier than I thought he'd go. Pretty real weight. Body weight class. Seems to be thinking about it just a little. I mean, looks a little serious. But not a real big deal. Guys are walking around on this platform, you can see. Guy standing on his platform. I mean, geez, that's only 210 kilos. Well, he smoked the 190. So, think about it just daily. Let's see. Big discussion with the coach. They're discussing it. He's reaching for the 2.5. I think the coach is saying, yep, that's it, you're done. He missed the first warm set with 90 reps, 140s this next set. Coach won the argument on the 2.10 was that final set. Got 180 going here now. I'm seeing a pretty classic Bulgarian workout. Snatch, clean and jerk, squash, and up. Yeah, pretty heavy and everything. 220. Oh, there goes the rack with it. Whoa. Now why worry about it? 220. Identify with that. They're 240 on here. 260, I lied. 'Cause I haven't seen to throw those fives on until the end. 260, anyway, that's it for work. Welcome back to the training hall. It's much more than about 10:30. Where you continue with Pablo Lara's story here. Pablo lives day after tomorrow. Done a couple of long sets. Still working with 50. I mentioned last night that I thought
that Sunay Balut wanted to go for 250 clean and jerk, but his coach held him back. I talked to him last night. He said he actually wanted to go to 220, but the coach said no, but he was ready to do 227 last night. Warm up.
I got 90 kilos.
It's really the whole Cuban team trains, it looks like, just following training diaries. They're using training diaries, and I think the loops look like they might be written out in advance. They're all walking around with their training diaries. Just in case you thought training diaries were just kind of a figment of someone's imagination, really, for beginners, all these world-class guys are lugging them. Well used, too. Really well worn. I
got 90 kilos going here again.
I never noticed this before, but pretty wide foot stance. We got 110 again. Remember, we're 2 days out at this point. And it's morning. It's about 10:45 now in the morning. Competition is at 5:30 p.m. for people interested in that. These power snatches.
No, this close, but these guys, they're doing
no rest at all. Just pulled off the outside 20s, and it's like we're going straight into clean and jerks.
instructions on the placement were the coach one of the feet end up. Coach, by the way, that's George Perez, was given a lot of very specific instructions pointing to the platform, I think saying where he wanted that front foot to go. George Perez right there. 130 again. Let's see what they say. Verbal instructions on his hand. But he's watching very closely. And he's looking down at the feet. He's watching the feet very closely on that point. Once again, he's studying the feet. He's looking straight at the feet. You know, he's giving Pablo some instructions to feed very specifically right before that jerk. Wish I spoke some Spanish, I could find out exactly what they're saying. 160. Instructions and a demo on a jerk. Pablo, who is happy with that jerk. Watch this, he's going to power clean this 160, just casual bet, throw in the squat racks. How do you like that? So real casual. And then probably go straight in the squats. Look at this. Here he goes. Set 160. Remember, this is the seventh. This is a lifter. I mean, you could probably go into a lot of Gold's gyms and find a lot of people how buffed up bodybuilders have come close to matching the horsepower of this guy. Not close. We got 200 kilos going here. I'll sit down and rest a few minutes on this set, in between sets. That easy, huh? Here we go with 200 again. I've been sitting here probably for about a half an hour watching the two full shitty 3 kilo lifters train. Lifting right now, and Shimon is coming up right now. It's amazingly quiet here. It's almost like being in church. They're just working out, going up very steadily, about 10 kilo lifts. Start off stretching easily, hardly any talking. Just real quiet and going through what's probably going to be a pretty light workout, but I probably better try to tape part of it, partly so you could get a feeling for what it's like. And also, for those of us who grew up reading about Polish training methods and strength and health, and see what the Poles are doing right now. A couple of 83s at work right here, 3 days out. Simone, it's up to 120. Thank you. These two guys, World Class 83s, just if you're interested, started off at 50 kilos and did several more upsets there, then went up to 70. And that was after quite a bit of stretching. But there's really, there's almost no talking here, just quiet, load, lift, load, lift. And even though it's quiet, it's funny, you can really feel the energy. That's what I was hoping to pick up a little bit of this for you, get a little bit of what it's like. It was 1:30. He's not using the straps. Most of the wooden sticks and straps at this point. Took off 10, they're back down to 130 for him. He's been going 10 kilos lighter in a bunch of the sets. This is 150. There are lifters training on three platforms right around here. I don't know if you can get a sense of how quiet it is. The lifters just aren't talking to each other, the Polish lifters. Just quiet. Everyone's just training really hard, and if they talk, they whisper. Probably the favorite to win this class, since Booster and Daidalos are not going to do it this contest. Can't emphasize how quiet it is. You know what a contrast it is to say a stereotypical powerlifting gym with heavy metal music and guys banging their heads against the wall. I feel like they're watching art here. It's really interesting. Okay, this will be 170. We're getting a pretty serious weight. Here we go with 170. Now I strip the bar down. came over and gave some pretty firm instructions. I'm not sure what it was he said. Shoflick more closely. He did really show quite a bit of flexibility. All of the poles were stretching and loosening up before they were touched away, starting off with really modest bleeds given their strength levels. So the fall was through from the beginning on the clean and jerks. This has been about a 10-minute break in between the snatches and clean and jerks. Even though it's probably, I don't know, maybe 75 degrees here, pretty humid, Shoflick went over and put on a jacket when he sat down to rest in between a snatch and clean jerk. And I noticed no one had a little conversation before starting. They were really, literally just whispering to each other. So nobody's wasting any energy talking as a Polish team. Just quiet and listening. The coach seems very stern. Loosening up the elbows and shoulders and wrists. And the jerk. And loosen up the shoulders a little bit more doing that. And getting that direct line for the drive by jerking in the neck. Same 70. Resting, jerk, but no recovery. See if that's just part of his warm up. Yep. He's easing into his recovery. Same pattern that we saw in the snatches. Lots of really light warm-up sets before we start putting weight on a bar. Mm-hmm. are guys who clean and jerk in the neighborhood at three times this amount of weight. You can see how many more upsets they're doing. I just wanted to tape this because you're going to see this all the time. Just tell guys, don't pick up their plates. They're rolling. I guess they must save all the energy for the lifts. 100. Doing full recovery from the jerk kind of surprises me at this point. See lots of sets at 100. Here's another one. You know, and for the percent guys, we're, you know, around 50% of what they're gonna do. Good shot, a good example, all the dynamic start, get set high, come down, start. Looks like they're going to 140 next. 140. Next. officer. I just first didn't want to tell him to stop walking. Big weight here. It's just 200 kilos. You can see it's getting sucked, but not too much. Big one. Name. So you can see there's a little conference going on here. And this guy did not win any Captains of Mirth Award that I've seen. Here's at 190. Coach just kind of glared at him. I don't know if it's just his general demeanor or something specifically about this guy or his training that he's unhappy about. Another conference going on here. I don't see anything interesting.